We're going to tell you the story of Peter and the Wolf. Each character in this tale is represented by a different instrument of the orchestra. The bird by the flute. Here's the duck, represented by the oboe. The cat by the clarinet. The grandfather by the bassoon. The wolf by the French horns. Peter by the strings in the orchestra. And the blast of the hunter's guns is represented by the timpani and the bass drum. Are you sitting comfortably? Are your cellular phones on silent? Then we shall begin. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. On the branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. "All is quiet," chirped the bird gaily. Soon, a duck came waddling around. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Duck, the little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to the duck, and shrugged his shoulders. "What kind of bird are you if you can't fly?" said he. To this the duck replied, "What kind of bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. The cat thought, "The bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him." Stealthily, she crept toward him on her velvet paws. "Look out!" shouted Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat, from the middle of the pond. The cat crawled around the tree and thought, "Is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away." Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone to the meadow. "This is a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do?" Thank you. paid no attention to his grandfather's words. Boys like him are not afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate. Had Peter gone, then a big gray wolf came out of the forest. In a twinkling, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked, and in her excitement, jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer and nearer, catching up with her. Her, and with one gulp, swallowed her. And now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. the bird on another. Not too close to the cat. While the wolf walked round and round the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only take care he doesn't catch you." The bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings while the wolf snapped angrily at him from this side and that. The bird did worry the wolf. How he wanted to catch him! But the bird was too clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. But Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope round his tail tighter. Just then, the hunters came out of the woods. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they came. But Peter, sitting in the tree, said, "Don't shoot! The bird and I have already caught the wolf. Now, help us take him to the zoo." And now, imagine the triumphant procession. Peter at the head. After him, the hunters leading the wolf. the procession. Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather tossed his head discontentedly. Well, and if Peter hadn't caught the wolf, what then? Peter and I, look what we have caught. And if you would listen very carefully, you could hear the duck quacking inside the wolf, because the wolf, in his haste, had swallowed her alive.
Welcome to Anna Musicology, everybody. Wasn't Wes Copeland fantastic? Can you hear me okay? I don't feel like I've got a lot of gain on this mic. Can you hear me okay? Okay. Well, welcome, and so glad to see you here. As many of you know, Wes Copeland is the director of our Center for the Arts and Sciences across the parking lot, and we had such a fun event there today. Can I see a show of hands? How many were able to join us this afternoon? And all right, a number of you. Thank you for coming out. And it was a really fun event. I think hopefully our kids had a great time. And I think we had a couple of pets adopted, and kids got to see some musical instruments. And it was just a really fun day. It was a beautiful day. And so just a great day celebrating music and celebrating animals. And that's what tonight is all about, too. That piece was so fun for us. While we're speaking about this afternoon, I really want to thank Rachel Clater and her committee for heading up the whole thing. So Rachel, if you're here, let's thank Rachel. I've had the pleasure lately to go back home to Brazoswood and work with some kids, and they were kind enough to provide some chamber ensembles for this afternoon and this evening. Did you enjoy them in the lobby this evening? Thank you guys. So our previous piece, we depicted some animals, but they were mostly small animals, like the bird, kind of a high sound, and the duck, kind of a mid-range sound, the duck, the cat. But we thought it's only fair to represent a larger animal with a lower sound. So for this next piece, it's from the Saint-Saëns Carnival of the Animals, and you're going to hear another movement from that piece, the first piece back after the intermission. But we thought Grace Lewis is no stranger to the stage, and we thought this would be fun to let you hear this piece. So it's you can imagine, you've seen the pictures of the elephant and the tutu doing, trying to be graceful, and that's what this piece is all about. It's kind of fun and kind of funny. And then we'll finish this set with the baby elephant walk. Henry Mancini from Hitari. They tell me I'm way too young to know what that movie is, but anyway, it's a lot of fun. So thanks again for being here, and we'll kind of set up for the elephant here, and we'll see you after the intermission. Thank you. Danby and Drew, weren't they fabulous? And Audrey Dunn, all night, Audrey Dunn. Yeah. So we've celebrated elephants, horses, dogs next, I think, dogs. So we're gonna, the first song we're gonna play, it's not a song, it's a movement from Enigma Variations, and if we play it up to speed, it's gonna take about 60 seconds or less. So this movement, Edward Elgar, a British composer, wrote several different movements of music for his friends. And this one was for George St. Clair, but he decided to write about his dog. He saw his dog fall into a river one day, and he was paddling like the Dickens to try to get out of the river, and so he thought this would be, he would just write this flurry of notes to depict that moment. So hopefully you can imagine a bulldog trying to run his way out of a muddy riverbank on the 11th movement of Enigma Variations. Then we are going to feature Debbie Sitka on, Linda's next, right? Are we walking the dog or is the dog biting? We're walking the dog next, yes. So George Gershwin wrote this really fun and cool piece for a movie called Shall We Dance? With Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers. And actually it was written the same year as Peter and the Wolf, 1936. And Linda has a lot of jazz experience. You sometimes see her on the corner of This Way and That Way by the Worst House on a Sunday afternoon playing with the Brazosport Big Band. And so she's going to bring that jazz influence to Walking the Dog by George Gershwin. And then finally, an Appalachian fiddle tune. Debbie Sitka has been with this orchestra for over 20 years and has never done a feature solo. It was time. So we're going to feature Debbie on a fiddle tune called Granny, Does Your Dog Bite? I contend that that this is one of the songs that Johnny beat the devil with. Think about it. Chicken in the bread pan, picking out dough. Granny, does your dog bite? No, child, no. So I think that's the case. We're not sure, but anyway, we hope you enjoy our tribute to dogs. Thank you. All right, so at this time I'd like to ask Paula Motzke to the stage to, she'll be here eventually, so. Any animal jokes? All right.
Oh,
this is gonna be fun.
Okay, hello everybody. I'm Paula Motzke and I'm president of the Brazosport Symphony Orchestra Council. Tonight you can just refer to me as grandfather.
Grandfather.
So I have a few announcements to make. I'd like to talk a little bit about the event this afternoon. We really appreciate all of our people who attended and the volunteers, especially the Buck Band kids. They were so helpful. So thanks, guys. We appreciate it. I have some statistics from the day. You know, our goal today was to get some animals adopted from the SPCA. And so I have great news. We adopted out one dog and one cat today. So two pets have a new home. Two pets. So we're happy. We're really happy. We hope there will be more. We had a lot of activity. We had a great amount of donations, supplies, and money donated to the SPCA. So thanks to everybody who participated in that. We feel like we had about 250 people over there. And so I think, it was a beautiful day. So we're really glad for everybody who helped. I'd like to thank the Brazosport Art League. They sent their teen guild over to do face painting, and those kids did a great job. So thanks to those guys. And we also had some, I don't know, I'll call them artists, sketchers. We had some members of the league who came and sat in rehearsal with us Thursday night and sketched musicians and did some really creative interpretations of the music and putting animals with us. So thanks to those folks. And if you haven't seen that art, it's out in the lobby. So make sure you pass by the boards and check it out on your way out. We just love them, and we will treasure those pieces they did for us. Brazosport College provided security and support today, and we really appreciate them and the Clarion. We just can't thank the college enough. Okay, so that's it for announcements. Now we have some fun. So we have a book tonight. We have a treat. We have a book that was donated by Ducky. Is Ducky here? Sheree, are you here tonight? Sheree and Glenn, are they here? Okay, so Sheree, now in McBride, also known as Ducky, she did this beautiful book. It's called Wild Bird Giclées by Ducky, and it's just a collection of prints of some of the artwork she's done, and it's narrated. It's got some verse in there also that Glenn, her husband Glenn McBride, helped her with. And so we're going to do a drawing for this beautiful autographed book tonight, and I need help. I need somebody to come up. Do you see somebody, Brian? Brian, I think Brian's going to try to find somebody to help us draw a name. So we're going to draw a chair, and if you happen to be in the lucky seat, you win the book. And if you don't, we'll draw another chair and another chair. Luckily, we have a good crowd, so we shouldn't have to draw too many. All right, we have a volunteer. Excellent. Oh, no. Okay, what's your name? Stand up here.
Jimena,
do you go to school here in Brazosport?
No.
Where do you go to school?
I go to Clute.
You go to Clute? Which school?
Intermediate.
Clute Intermediate. Awesome. And?
Yes.
What instrument do you play?
The oboe.
She plays the oboe. That's awesome. You know, I play the bassoon. A lot of people think the bassoon is the oboe, but it's not. The bassoon could eat the oboe. That's how you can tell what it is. It's much bigger. Okay, so first we're going to draw a row. So pick a row. Tell me what you got.
I got an F.
An F. So everybody in row F, somebody in row F is going to be very lucky tonight. Okay, I'll take the F. All right, now we've got to pick a seat number. So pick one that's got a person in it, okay?
F14.
Do we have a bingo? Do we have somebody in that seat? No. Okay. We have to draw again. Oh, we do. Harry Sargent. I think I saw him move. Did you move? Okay. Come on up, Harry Sargent. Okay. Thank you very much. And I hope we see you up here on stage someday. Okay. All right. Thanks. Good night. here for her. Yes. I'm going to need to validate this. Give me one. Just a minute, Harry Sergeant. Did you pencil that in? Okay, F-14. Congratulations, Harry. Thank you. Make sure you check out Harry's art out in the lobby. Two more things. I want to thank our conductor, Brian Casey, for his vision for today, for the event and the concert. He's just amazing, and let's hear it for Brian. I mean, it's great. And finally, if you don't know about the Center for the Arts and Sciences, Bet on the Arts Gala, New Year's Eve, check it out. There's information out in the lobby. Thanks for coming.
All right, we're going to close the evening with Cats. Hey, I want to see you back. This is a great audience, and spread the word about December 18th. I see a few members of the Brazosport College Choir and Community Choir that were up here last week with a fantastic concert. I'll tell you, the clarion, all cylinders are clicking. It's just everything that's in here is just gold right now, and we're so proud to have this facility and have such talent in our area. And so we're looking forward to the Messiah on December 18th. It's going to be amazing. And then look forward to the Brazosport Symphony Orchestra, our first concert, Playing with Fire, in February. Just music depicting fire. It's going to be some intense music, and it's going to be a lot of fun and a lot that you recognize. Then Bobby Wazell, I think he's known as Robert now, Dr. Robert Wazell, the Dean of Music at Kansas, University of Kansas, but he's one of our own, and we're going to have him back to do the Artie Shaw Clarinet Concerto and a lot of really fun music. And then finally, the Whit Phillips Young Artist Competition winners in May. So anyway, a lot of great stuff coming up. Get it on your calendar, because you're not going to want to miss it. So we will, we're going to play a tuning note and then end the evening with Cats, and hope you enjoy our little slideshow as we play Memory. So thanks again for coming.
Thank you.
Give us just a second. That's kind of noisy. So I think we just want to hear the beginning of Lion King without the screen noise. So, did you enjoy the musicians with their pets? I think the Crummels won the prize for tuxedoing up and putting bow ties on their dogs. That's next level right there. And there wasn't a costume contest tonight, but if there had been, Terry Sandlin and Nelda Ahlquist would have won. So congratulations to you guys. All right, Lion King, hope you enjoy it.